What's up? Thanks for checking me out. Well, I'm back again with another movie review. Don't worry, you don't have to see my ugly face today. I'm just gonna throw some pictures up. But anyway, I'm back talking about this brand new X-Men movie called The X-Phoenix Dark Force. No, wait. The Phoenix Force Dark Phoenix. No, damn it. X-Men Phoenix Force. No, whatever. Okay, the new X-Men movie. Well, anyway, I know you heard online and Twitter about people just really ragging on this movie and going hard on it, calling it SJW nonsense, calling it woke. And you know what I do on this channel? I rip apart movies like that all the time. I let you know what's up with that nonsense they got in movies. And this movie had plenty of it. I'm not even gonna lie. I'm gonna tell you straight up. This movie had plenty of that woke nonsense, I guess you wanna call it, all up and through the movie from beginning to the end. So I'm gonna get into it a little more detailed than that. I'm basically gonna break down the plot of the movie a little bit and then, you know, just give you my thoughts on how it came across. So we start off this movie with the president calling up Professor X, asking Professor X for help, saying we got some NASA astronauts, they stuck in space in this shuttle and we need your team to go pull them out, you know, and bring them back to Earth. So that was the plan. So Professor X, you know, he puts his team together, they throw him in the X-Jet and then they send him up there to space. And I think that was a really cool scene, you know, because the special effects were on point. They used every member of the team, Quicksilver, Nightcrawler, even Jean Grey got in there and used her powers. Cyclops, he used his powers to blast some shit. So that whole shuttle scene was one of the best probably from the X-Men universe because it was creative, it was thoughtful, I thought. And I like when they use the team together to use their powers. So after they were saving all the astronauts, they needed Jean Grey to hold the shuttle together while they secured the last couple of them. And when she went in there to do that, that's when that big nebula is what they thought. It really was the Phoenix Force, but they thought it was like a big red nebula. That's when it overtook her. And I mean, it was giant size, the size of a planet, you know, this whole force, this mist looking thing was. And it all went inside of her. And she, you know, went unconscious and they got her and brought her back to Earth. And that's when she was endued with the Phoenix Force. They didn't know that at the time, you know, it was kind of new to them, but they knew that her power levels were off the scales because Beast, he did some sort of analysis on her and he said, well, you're completely off the charts. Like, I can't even measure how strong you are anymore because my machine doesn't measure that high. So she was on a different level of strength and she had telepathy, telekinesis. She could move shit with her mind. She could read your thoughts. She could fly. I mean, it was just on the crack and pretty much she could touch you and make you disintegrate like Thanos did with the snap. So yeah, she was snapping fools all over the place. So yeah, she came back with all these crazy powers. But when they also came back, that's when we start getting some of that woke nonsense from Mystique. That's when she gave Professor X that line that we all saw when she said, oh, you should turn us into the X-Women because the women is always saving the men around here. And I actually agree with that. And I think that she didn't realize what she said was actually my point in general about movies as a whole. Why is the men always the idiots and got to get saved by the women? Like, what the fuck is going on with Hollywood? And I see people making comments in the comment section about what makes movie SJW nonsense. It's bullshit like that. When every single time the men have to get saved by the women because the man is an idiot, he can't fight, can't shoot, can't do nothing. So yeah, thanks Mystique for proving my point or pointing out the obvious. But then we get along in the story and it pretty much has Jean Grey going to, I guess, find her father because the whole incident with her being a kid and her parents in the front seat, well, it was caused by Jean Grey. She basically made her mom go unconscious and her mom ran into oncoming traffic. But Professor X, he sort of blotted that out and made it seem like it never happened or it wasn't her fault. So I guess you could say she found out Professor X is full of shit and a liar and that her father was alive and that the accident really was her fault. So she goes and find her father and her father still can't, you know, stand her ass. He hates her. He gave her away to Professor X because she was a mutant and he said, I can't control her no more. So she finds all this out while she's talking to her dad. And then that's when you get the scene where the X-Men show up and she pushes Mystique, you know, with the helicopter right there. And she's just like, get away, get away. And then she pushes her with her powers. Well, Mystique, she flies and goes into a gate, kills Mystique. And that's the end of her for the whole movie. There's no bringing her back. There's no resurrections this time. But it really wasn't that impactful. It didn't really feel like anything. It was just like, oh, thank God, that bitch who complained the whole movie is finally dead. Now she can shut the fuck up about this feminist nonsense and let me watch a comic book movie. So anyway, after she does this murder, Jean Grey gets up and she leaves and she goes to find Magneto. And Magneto is on some sort of mutant farm because he has all his buddies there. And Jean Grey pretty much tells him everything that's going on with her and these powers, but she doesn't tell him that she killed Mystique. And then the government comes, you know, the army comes there to Magneto's little form, and they want Jean Grey because of what she did, you know, blowing up all those police cars, killing Mystique, causing mayhem, and the government wants to take her back. So these troops arrive and she just dismantles their helicopters, one of them. They have two. She dismantles one of them. All the other troops, they get on the last helicopter and get their ass on out of there with the assist of Magneto. Now Magneto tells Jean Grey, you got to get your crazy ass up out of here because I don't need to protect anybody but these mutants I have here, protect them from your crazy ass. So she leaves, and that's when she comes into Jessica Chastain's character, Vuk. Now Vuk, they never really describe what or who she is. They just say she's an alien and she has some other alien buddies with her. Now Jessica Chastain may be a great actress, but in this role she was completely just dry, wooden, stone cold Steve Austin type shit. I don't know, it was just a waste of a character. And the whole thing about her getting the Phoenix Force from Jean Grey is a big contradiction, because if I remember at the beginning of the movie, they said the Phoenix Force chose Jean Grey. So if the Phoenix Force is this unstoppable force that can burn up whole planets and civilizations, and it chose to go inside Jean Grey, then how can Jean Grey later on in the movie decide to hug and make out with Jessica Chastain character and give her some of the Phoenix Force? Shouldn't that just blow her up? The Phoenix Force didn't choose Jessica Chastain's character. The Phoenix Force chose Jean Grey. So it's a big contradiction there within the whole movie itself. And it's a damn shame because this is the last movie from Fox making the X-Men. So it's just a big ass plot hole that just stands out to me. Anyway, we get to the end of the movie and we get to this train scene. And that's where probably one of the coolest scenes in the X-Men universe. You know, this whole train where they have all the X-Men tied up and they're taking them back to the base. And then you have Jean Grey realize that she wants to be a good guy now, and she comes to save the day, and they have a nice battle. And that's where you get some really badass Magneto scenes. Nightcrawler does some cool shit. Even Beast get a couple scenes. But I like the fact that they let us see Magneto get all these guns and shit, and just really this empty clips on Jessica Chastain's character doesn't really affect her. She just knocks him out like it's nothing. And then Jean Grey comes at the end and flies the bitch up into space and blows her up with the Phoenix Force, and that's the end of the movie. This movie is not all bad. I mean, I'm not gonna say it's what people are saying online, that it's just SJW nonsense, because there are scenes that just make you cringe with some of the lines they have. Like the material, the way it's written is real poor, and I think it's kind of pathetic, and some of the actors and actresses are going through the motions. And I guess it's because of what they're reading in the script. The whole thing about calling them ex-women, and you know, just I can go on and on. But I really want to talk more or less about the more inner workings of the action, and you know, just how I came across as a fan, because it's not all bad as people say. Sophie Turner, she came through with a great performance. I thought she did the best she could do with the material that she was given. I felt like, of course, James McAvoy, Michael Fassbender, they're gonna deliver no matter what. So I thought they brought it. You have some characters that try their best and some action scenes that are really cool. So it's not a horrible, terrible movie. But at the same time, I think that some of the writing and the editing, like you can even say Jessica Chastain wasn't even there in person, that she was just part of the reshoots, because there's certain scenes where people aren't even looking at her and she's talking. So it's like bad editing like that and bad lines just make you roll your eyes when you're watching this movie, and it really takes away from some of the action and I guess you can say balances it out to be an average ass movie at best. And then that's sad. It's not even infuriating. It's sad because this is the last movie from Fox making their X-Men movies, and now they're gonna go to the MCU. So I know Kevin Feige's probably gonna do a really good job with, you know, the X-Men going forward. And I'll make a video on that talking about how they should proceed with the X-Men going forward. But as far as this being the last movie, it wasn't even so much to make you angry. It just was a disappointment and an average movie at best. I give this movie flat in the middle, 5 out of 10. I can't recommend you go see it in the theater. I do recommend if you come out on Redbox, if you're a fan of comic book movies, just give it a watch on a Redbox, something like that. But yeah, don't waste your time and money going to the theater for this nonsense. Anyway, y'all, that's just my thoughts. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Anyway, y'all, this is my thoughts. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Was you feeling this movie? Was you thinking one of the top comic book movies of all time? Or did you think it was an average movie and it was disappointing to be the last one from Fox? Let me know in the comment section below. Don't forget to like, subscribe to the channel, y'all. It's much appreciated. And I'll catch your ass out there in this universe. Peace.
You're threatening me.
That's right.